We have not qualified 2024 prelims, or we are beginning with our preparation for 2025 examination. What should be our approach of study? Our approach of study must be oriented towards something that is customized, something that is very well planned, so that I utilize this complete year favorably. I am here to talk about one of the most successful programs that I am running since the COVID times. It is called Comprehensive Synthesis Training Program. It is 1 year answer writing practice program, which is basically charted out to generate confidence among the students that the content enrichment is done only by specifications of the requirement. CSTP this year, that will mark up its beginning from 28th of July, will be having additional feature of handwritten notes provided. This program is significant for those students who are done with their syllabus of geography optional. And many successful candidates in last few years have been the enrolled students of CSTP with me. What is the requirement and how exactly it works on in the favor of your prelims orientation also? Let me begin with this fact. Once you have taken the negative result of prelims, what readily crops up in your mind is that I'm not very well prepared with prelims and I should readily get on to the MCQs. And MCQ solving, without any doubt, is the most important thing to understand what exactly are the problems that you are facing in cracking, in making the correct choices of the preliminary examination. But I think all of you will agree to me that prelims preparation requires to be more subjective. What is the reason? That the simple question as international border between the following country, which is the lengthiest one, goes out of our hand because I have not made the clarity of the fundamentals of the things. You have to understand that from main comes in the prelims preparation. Until and unless the concepts are clear, you won't be in the position of doing justice with your prelims question. That is the reason targeting 2025, taking the benefit of the overlap that general studies has with geography optional, this program have been charted out. This program incorporates a very nominal fee. I have not increased it. It is significantly beneficial to all of you. And as I've said, it incorporates a new feature of handwritten notes provided. What exactly is the orientation with which we work? Understand it like this. With very minimal sample of syllabus in front of me, as I said, we'll be beginning it from 28th of July. So we have charted out the syllabus on the monthly basis, like your beginning block where you'll be attempting your preparation. It will include oceanography, climatology and Indian climate. And what exactly is the purpose with which we are trying to apply? It is basically to give you the comprehensive approach of study. When I say comprehensive approach of study, you need to understand that I need to have as elaborate, as a subjective approach of learning as possible to qualify my examination. It incorporates the orientation of giving you micro perspective to the syllabus. I'll just open up how we have charted out the syllabus. It will give you the understanding of what is this micro perspective. Micro perspective is what I very strongly insist in, because when you take that every topic is of same importance, you are basically doing justice with your preparation. If you are not reading out every topic with the similar level of importance, somewhere your preparation is not foolproof. It orients towards enhancing formatting practice of answer. Always understand that answer framing is different from notes making. When you are done with a certain topic, you chart out some snippet of the information. As ultimately of these 5 pages, this is the 5 points that I can create a synopsis of, which will help me to retain it. But when you are framing the answer, it will be requiring the demand of the question. So notes making is not synonymous to answer framing. You have to get on to the framing up of the answer. It automatically talks about creating time management. When I say creating time management, you need to generate out the logic, the importance that there is a time restriction in examination hall, and I must be justifying that time restriction to make maximum of my efforts. Case study integration. Case studies are being largely applied as examples. You are coming across multiple news items as you are daily handling your newspapers. How it has to be integrated with your syllabus? It has to be integrated with your syllabus by understanding the syllabus, by understanding that this is the constituent of my syllabus, by taking the logic that I need to create out my content as per this point is overlapping with this part of my syllabus. This is what is called micro perspective. Have you ever taken up, and let me add it on, general studies integration? So many times I have emphasized that when you try to see your geography syllabus and try to overlap with your general studies syllabus, it comes out so clear that your general studies 1 and your general studies 3 has a significant share that overlaps with geography. Locational factors of primary, secondary, tertiary, quaternary activities of world including India, earthquake, volcanism, relief features, or general studies 3 where you have to talk about everything from agriculture to mining to industry, transport, civil aviation, information communication technology, all of them are there in your syllabus. And not just this, if you see the 2024 prelims paper, or for that matter 2023 prelims paper, you have got the questions that are directly coming from the hardcore conventional geography. And that gives you the justification that I need to be comfortable with the fundamental concepts. Prelims qualification is not hit and trial method. You have to be very clear with your base. MCQs will help only when you are done with your fundamentals. So the purpose of CSTP is to give you that micro perspective of the syllabus. And that micro perspective of the syllabus, please try to see it like this. As I said, we'll be beginning it from 28th July. So what is the block we are covering? Oceanography, climatology and Indian climate. I want this complete month frame coming in front of us. And please take note of it very rationally. What exactly is the purpose of CSTP? Utilizing the time factor very clearly. So, can you notice that here you are picking up the micro divides of the syllabus? I mean, it is not going comprehensive. On 28th of July, you will just be revising bottom topography of the three oceans that is there in our syllabus. Ocean water, temperature, salinity. You are taking up reference of heat and salt budget. Matlab, you are simply taking the revision of three topics of your oceanography, which will incorporate the hypsometric curve or bathymetry, which will give you the ocean water heat budget with ocean water density, and it is also salinity and how it is influencing the, you know, it has got a feedback relation when it comes on to the temperature and thereby the density of the water. Once you are done with this weekly task, these three topics of oceanography will be fully done. And then when you take the leap to the next week, it is deposits, ocean water movement, marine resources, which biotic mineral energy resources included, coral reefs with coral bleaching, sea level changes, laws of seas, and marine pollution. Are you noticing syllabus is such clearly divided that it gives you all the logic that on the weekly basis you are taking that micro units of your syllabus, preparing it, revising it, you have created your notes, and now you are attempting the answer to them. So week by week, your confidence level in timely revising your content, creating time management will continue. And it goes on, it completely goes on with this. I just want to take first month's, I have attached PDF, you can see that. 11th August, you will take up climate, temperature, pressure, belt of world, heat budget of earth, atmospheric circulation, stability, instability, planetary and local winds. When you are taking atmospheric circulation, by default planetary and local winds will come in. You have such clear divides of the syllabus that revision becomes much more defined. It's not open-ended. कि भाई ओशियानोग्राफी प्रिपेयर करके आ जाना कमिंग संडे के टेस्ट के लिए. ओशियानोग्राफी के तो बहुत सारे टॉपिक्स हैं, क्लाइमेटोलॉजी के बहुत सारे टॉपिक्स हैं. इफ यू सी प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस, वी हैव गॉट क्वेश्चंस ऑन मैकेनिज्म ऑफ इंडियन मॉनसून इन पेपर वन, मैकेनिज्म ऑफ इंडियन मॉनसून इन पेपर टू. दैट इज द लॉजिक विद विच वी हैव इंटीग्रेटेड इंडियन क्लाइमेट, एंड दिस इज वेयर वी हैव टेकन अप मॉनसून्स, जेट स्ट्रीम्स, मैकेनिज्म ऑफ इंडियन मॉनसून, रेनफॉल पैटर्न, ट्रॉपिकल साइक्लोन, वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंसेस, क्लाइमेटिक रीजन्स ऑफ इंडिया. Because that will give you the completion. Because when you learn, when you study in class, you try to be segregated with every topic. But when you are now into writing practice, it is revision cycle that you are into. You need to become integrated with your approach. And our syllabus is very well charted out like this. Like this is month one. This will be our month two. This is how it goes. And it completely goes with very well charted out syllabus. And take my word, it has been the mind-blowing, beyond expectation orientation of grooming students towards all the key pointers that facilitate them in attaining good marks. I'm just coming on to that. It is perspectives in development of human geography combined with models, theories, laws in human geography that do not have anything to do with your general studies for sure. But this is one of the most difficult topics that most of the students identify. That is the reason, again, charted out into the blocks, which gives me the understanding that I'm done with it. Like 29th September, you will be attempting dichotomy and dualism. Now, there are many students of geography optional who are still stuck up with what is the similarity or difference between dichotomy and dualism. You get the clarity of that. Environmentalism, quantitative revolution and locational analysis. Jaise hi aap locational analysis lete ho, von Thunen's agricultural location model or Alfred Weber's industrial locational model, wo to aapke syllabus mein models, theories, laws in human geography mein likha hua hai. So there is a sort of integration that you are developing, and that integration is the key to write the logical answer. So our syllabus is completely charted out, and because we are targeting 2025, and by default will be appearing for 2025 prelims examination, so appropriately we have got the demarcated prelims break also. So you take the reference of एग्रीकल्चर इंडिया आ गया, पूरा सिलेबस बहुत क्लियरली डिफाइंड है. इसमें कोई भी टॉपिक आपके सिलेबस का हम छोड़ नहीं रहे हैं, हर टॉपिक को रैशनली सब डिवाइड किया है. प्रीलिम्स ब्रेक के बाद जब आप दोबारा शुरू करोगे तब आपके पास बर्डन बहुत कम रह जाएगा. आपने प्रीलिम्स एग्जामिनेशन दिया दो महीने, जून एंड एज आई सेड जुलाई 27th आप कंप्लीट कर लेंगे अपना साइकिल. दिस इज हाउ इट गोज. जब आप अपने ईयर को इस तरह से प्लान करोगे, आपको बेनिफिट क्या मिलेगा? आपको बेनिफिट मिलेगा ऑफ कॉन्फिडेंस दैट आई एम डन विद एवरी टॉपिक ऑफ माय सिलेबस. आई हैव जेनरेटेड द कॉन्फिडेंस ऑफ राइटिंग द आंसर इन टाइम मैनेजमेंट पर व्यू. व्हाट आर द डिफाइंड ऑब्जेक्टिव्स दैट वी टेक अप विद इट? लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड इट नाउ. आर CSTP सिग्निफिकेंटली ओपन इट्स पर्सपेक्टिव ऑन कस्टमाइज स्ट्रैटेजी. I want each one of you to realize your own potentials, your own weakness, your own areas of strength, your own areas of, lagads, lacking, where you have to work on. That is the reason the first thing that you will be learning in this program is brainstorming. The second thing that you will be learning is creating mind map. Ready mental frame. The third thing is what we call six thinking hats. Six thinking hats is a very interesting concept. I have evolved that in our approach of preparation. It basically grooms us towards integrating the things. It is about integration capacity, because you need to understand that when you are preparing, you are trying to be perfect with every head. Anything, land capability, land resource management, hazard risk mitigation, because these are the topics which are there in general studies also. But once you come across the question where you have to take up the example of how the land resource mapping proves to be insufficient in handling the land resource or land related hazard mitigation, I need to develop that multiple dimensions of thinking. That is called six thinking hats. Number four is creativity. Minded creativity is key to attain good marks. That is the reason I say presently UPSC examination is not textbook oriented. It is not that you don't require to read the textbook. I have been very clear. If you are taking support of classes, textbook reading is negligible, barring the exception of NCERTs. You are being advised, na read karo in textbook because that will give you vocabulary, that will give you language. I say language and vocabulary are very well built up while reading in newspapers. In place of repeating the same thing that you have learned in class, by reading the textbook, I advise you to read newspaper in that time. That will give you the orientation of generating creativity, linking up, thinking on your own, creating something which has got your spectral signature. It is yours, and that is what will make examiner give you better marks than your competitor. Number five is lateral thinking. This is contemporary and conventional to be related. Don't take them to be poles apart. Every conventional item can have a contemporary edge, and every contemporary thing can be linked up with the conventional fact. You have to develop it. And I always say, you need to be aware of the topic to write. But because you are aware of the topic, you can write. It's a myth. Because writing is not just putting your thought in words. Writing is to answer the problem that has been given to you as a question. It may ask you to integrate multiple topics of your syllabus. It may ask you to integrate conventional to contemporary. So you have to generate that kind of thinking. And the very important thing is geographical perspective. That is handling diagrams, illustrations, map like pro, so that you are gaining a better orientation of your answer frame. These six objectives is what I have clearly charted out, and that is definitely going to help you. This year prelims examination, 32 questions from geography. I have given you the analysis of that already. It is there on the YouTube channel, you can see it. And note that all those who have prepared geography with elaborate requirement have handled those questions excellently. So you have to generate out that strong confidence that yes, I am in the position of doing it because I have picked up a comprehensive, no shortcut involved approach of strategy. So a negative prelims result is a setback, but I have to bounce back and plan out my year accordingly so that I'm not repeating the same mistake next year. So we have opened up the admissions for CSTP, Comprehensive Synthesis Training Program. You have to take understanding that time-bound preparation with a logic of frame is very important to attain success. So I welcome all of you who are willing to join in, and those who have joined in, you have got your schedule with you. Just try to be on the preparation track so that it is not just a formality that you are following, it is actually the task done. Become pro in geography handling, and there is nothing that can stop you from attaining the success in civil services examination. Bye-bye from my side for the time being.